Hi guys, this is Zemanjaski. I'm recording this the day after the daily event. Unfortunately, there's no exciting conclusion to round 4. As some of you will know, MTGO, the client, crashed and was taken down for about a day for maintenance, so I didn't get to finish the daily event. Nonetheless, I just want to do a brief recap on the deck and sort of postulate and on some potential changes. I have a Grand Prix trial coming up this weekend, so I'm still very much heavily involved in tuning the deck for that event. Just sort of reviewing just cards and ideas in the deck, starting with the mana base. I do like the 3 Guildgate, 3 Mutavault split, but I also really like the idea of having access to the 4th Mutavault in the sideboard. There are absolutely matchups where you really, really need to hit your 4th land you know, in a very timely manner. If not on turn 4, then turn 5. And having a 24th land does make a difference when doing that. And that the land itself will eventually turn sideways when you start to flood out means that I think it's actually a very viable sideboarding strategy against the control decks, where you really do need to hit your land drops so that you don't get constrained on mana and can cast your spells in a timely fashion. What else? I'm going through some different ideas for sideboarding against mono black, mono blue. It's not clear to me whether I want to like take out all of my creatures but Phoenix to deny their removal value, because you can obviously just, if they're going to have to use removal on Chandra's Phoenix, then you get every burn spell will have draw one attached to it thereafter, or you get the all burn draw, which makes their removal dead card, so you generate card advantage that way. So that's one strategy. I've been doing well with that, but the problem with it is it just feels like every game is so hard to win, and I have to play much better than my opponent to win. So I don't think that's actually a good strategy. I think I'm just outplaying worse players. So I want to be aggressive, but I don't have a particularly aggressive setup for that matchup. Now, I've toyed with bringing in First Blade, which should be good because mono black players should be taking out Lifebane Zombie against me. It's very bad against Searing Blood. It gives value to Magma Jet, but most players aren't good enough to take it out, so it's actually awkward bringing in First Blade. What I've been thinking of doing is actually switching Fire Drinker Satyr in my sideboard for Young Pyromancer, and while that might sound crazy, let me try and sell you an argument. Fire Drinker Satyr exclusively comes in for control decks. Blue Eye Control, Esper Control, Bant. Decks like that. Where I just want to play it on turn 1 and turn it sideways a bunch. That's all he does. With only 13 turn 1 red sources post-board, I can't always turn 1 a Fire Drinker Satyr, and they're not a particularly strong top deck. And they also have no synergy with the deck strategy. It's just a 2-power 1 drop. None of my other cards interact with it at all. The idea for Young Pyromancer against control is, yes, it's a turn 2 play, but often that's the best I can do anyway. And for one in a red, I can always cast it, whereas Ash Zealot can be difficult to cast on turn 2, so that flexibility is nice. But what it means is all the spells that I'm going to be casting on my opponent's end step basically just put an extra 1 power into play. So it's just it's a 2-1, exactly like Fire Drinker Satyr, but it has the upside of making every other burn spell in my deck, which there'll be, you know, nearly 30 post-board, substantially better. The counter-argument to that is, it's two counter-arguments. One, that's bad against Wrath, to which I say you're wrong, because, I mean, the burn spells are going to have to go at my opponent anyway. So the value is free, and if my board gets Wrathed, my board gets Wrathed. I only invested the one card, the Young Pyromancer. The 1/1 tokens were free value, and if they did any damage at all, then I should be getting ahead. But I also do have access to 4 Boros Charm, so if I have a board of like 3 or 4 tokens plus a Young Pyromancer, and my opponent's big play to win is Supreme Verdict to save himself, and I have the Boros Charm, then I probably just win instantly. So it actually gives the deck almost free win draws against like blue-white control, who could have a lot of trouble against a lot of difficulty removing Young Pyromancer, because they can either remove the Pyromancer or remove the tokens, and neither often neither is a good option. So that's you know, Wrath is not really an issue at all. What is a bigger issue is Jace, because Fire Drinker Sator fights Jace quite well, whereas Young Pyromancer obviously fights it much worse. But at the same time, like, my deck is not a swarm deck, and just having Young Pyromancer having a body in play is a lot like First Blade having a body in play. It stops Jace from minus two-ing, which is really valuable, because that's one of the only ways I lose, is when Jace can minus two twice to find them enough land to chain Revelations. Jace plus one-ing isn't very effective against my deck, because again, I've only invested one card in the Young Pyromancer. All the tokens are free from the burn spells I need to cast anyway, and it constrains their Jace. So I don't think it's that bad, and this deck's actually quite good at dealing with Jace. You know, a lot of the times you can just activate a Mutavolt and burn him. You know, cast a burn spell on your end step, activate Mutavolt, you know, swing the Young Pyromancer, kill Jace, and then you're in that really nice position of, yes, you need to Wrath, or all my tokens will kill you. So I think Young Pyromancer, overall, not as good against control decks as Fire Drinker Sator, but he's pretty much better everywhere else. The card is very good against Mono Black, for exactly the reason it fights Desecration Demon so well, which is one of the really problematic cards for my deck, and it completely neuters Desecration Demon. It's also, like, Bile Blight is an issue, but they can either Bile Blight Young Pyromancer, or they can Bile Blight your tokens. And if they Bile Blight your tokens, you're going to be, you know, you're running 26 plus burn spells, you'll be able to make more tokens. So, yes, that's a problem. Like, it's frustrating, but it's much less problematic than you might think. And I think the card has sort of been unfairly dismissed. I actually think Young Pyromancer might be a lot better positioned than even when we were discussing the deck of Dice to Removal, even better than we thought. And we're huge fans of the card. Now, Drown in Sorrow is a card, but Mono Black, at least online, has really moved away from Drown in Sorrow, so I suspect that's not really an issue. So, I actually think Young Pyromancer is going to be, I'm going to try it in a future video. I think it's going to be very good against Mono Black. I also like Young Pyromancer a lot against Mono Blue. I played the Pyromancer deck with Chandra last season, and what Young Pyromancer lets you do is exactly the same as Fire Dancer. It lets you use all of your burn spells to kill creatures, and then just kill them with your resulting board of Young Pyromancer and tokens. So you basically play as a tempo deck where you play out a threat that they can't answer because their deck doesn't run any removal, and then just kill everything they play for a couple of turns, and you have this massive overwhelming board presence that just kills your opponent. That's really, really, really good way of fighting that deck, because it one, prevents them from building up Devotion, which is their biggest strength, but two, it makes all of their god cards like Bident, like, worthless, because they just don't have a board presence. So it fights both powerful elements of their decks on a direct axis that also leads to victory. So I really like Young Pyromancer against that deck. And if you're forced into a racing situation where you need to get damage in the air with Phoenix and over the top with burn spells, the Young Pyromancer tokens can buy you a lot of time. You know, they trade with Master of Waves tokens, for example, or they can chump Frostburn Weird. That's really, really, really valuable. The card also, unlike Ash Zealot, which just has no luck at all against... Sorry, people are trying to chat to me. Sorry. Just let him know. Talk to him later. Unlike Ash Zealot, which has trouble against Frostburn Weird and, you know, Master of Waves or Tidebinder Mage, Young Pyromancer is at least continually creating value. So, I think the card is quite good there. It's also very good against, like, a green-white aggro deck or the mono-black aggro deck, where, you know, you're not going to get blown out like Sator Fire Dancer can sometimes be blown out. Instead, what happens is, you know, you have to use all your burn spells on your opponent's creatures, which doesn't get that wonderful Searing Blaze effect, but, again, you just one-for-one all of your opponent's creatures, and you're left with this overwhelming board presence that then kills them before they can recover. So, I really think I'm going to try Young Fire Dancer in the sideboard. I think the main deck, I'm really happy with it as it is. I like our sideboarding plans with Blind Obedience and Chain to the Rocks against green-red monsters. I really like Viashino First Blade and the extra land against Control. So I want to try Young Pyromancer. I think that'll apply across a couple of different matchups. I will concede that continually losing to Hexproof is getting frustrating. I've only faced the deck 6 times online, and 2 of them happened to be when recording for Channel Fireball, so kind of annoying, and it almost makes me want to sideboard a single glaring spotlight just to try and steal a win here or there, or maybe even 2 copies somehow. But if you're preparing for a paper event, I wouldn't bother with that at all. I would, if you need a deck, this is the 75 I would suggest right now. But definitely give me your opinions on Young Pyromancer. Give me your opinions on the 75. Let me know what you think. Like I said, I'm competing in a Grand Prix trial this weekend to go to Grand Prix Nagoya in Japan. So I'd really like to win and travel to Japan. So tell me what you think about the deck. Tell me what you think about the videos. And I should have another article up on Channel Fireball soon. So until then, this is James Fazzolari for ChannelFireball.com. Thanks for watching.